All right, let's jump over and talk about my Lakers a little bit here. D'Angelo Russell potentially sticking around in LA. This is from Michael Scotto of Hoopsite. Said, according to D'Lo, said, I'd love to be here and continue to give it a run and be where my feet are now. Obviously, I've been on the other side of it, and I've been through the roller coaster of free agency and having to sit back and wait. I'm looking forward to not having to worry about that. I've been blessed enough to put myself in this position with my play. I'm definitely planning on taking advantage of that. When that time comes, I feel that everything will play out how it's supposed to play out. D'Angelo Russell's free agency is going to be fascinating. He's played wonderful basketball overall for the Lakers this season. He had a bit of a slump there in December, but that since then, he's been fantastic. He's shooting the hell out of the basketball. He's given the team everything they need, especially on the offensive end of the floor. And now it's almost a certainty that he is not going to pick up that $18.7 million player option for this summer. The question is, how much is he going to get? And part of this is always the market at large. How many actual landing spots are there for D'Angelo Russell? How much money is there out there on the market? And how many teams are looking for a point guard right now? So, Keith, how do you see this whole situation playing out? And do you agree with me that it's all but certain that D'Lo is opting out of that player option?
Yeah, I think to that last part, I think that's definitely true. I think when you look at Russell with the player option, one, even if he doesn't make significantly more money than the $18.7 million he could get on that player option, it's more about the security of locking in 3 or 4 yes. years moving forward. Not that he's not like a 33-year-old who's like last big contract here, but it's just you want to lock it in. This is a guy who's been traded now a few times. He's been moved around quite a bit. So I think he would like to, wherever he goes next, stay there and settle. And clearly for him, it sounds like he'd like to stay with the Lakers. Now, I think the other thing that's important then is you start looking at, all right, what does the market look like? Well, of the free agent point guards, I would argue D'Angelo Russell is probably the best one that has a realistic chance of changing teams. So you can rank these guys in whatever order you want, but it's guys like James Harden, Drew Holiday, Tyrese Maxey, Emmanuel Quickley. Those, I think, guys I would have all ahead of Russell in the pecking order of free agent point guards, but none of them seem very likely to change teams. They all seem extremely likely to stay right where they are. Maxey and Quickley are restricted free agents. Maxey, we know what's going on there. Philly's going to sign him one way or another. Quickley, the Raptors talked about, we traded for him because we have control and we can keep him. Harden and Holiday probably not going anywhere. So then you get into a mix of players like D'Lo, Markelle Fultz, Tyus Jones, Spencer Dinwiddie, Monte Morris, Russell Westbrook. It starts to drop off fairly quickly at that point. So what at that point you start looking at is, all right, well, Russell's the next best guy, in my opinion, of that group, because everybody else there is either older, there's something that causes them to be a little less reliable. Where Russell is, you kind of know what he is. So then you flip to, what does the cap space look like and who has it and who needs a point guard? And that's where it gets a little questionable of, all right, well, Philly's probably not going there because Maxey's their guy.
Yeah,
Thunder definitely don't need any guards. The Spurs, yeah, that could maybe be interesting. Utah's got guards. So now you start looking at Orlando, Detroit, maybe. Do they want to make a play? Is there a team that would say, hey, we'll get involved in a sign-in trade? And those are all the factors they have to break down. I would say for D'Angelo Russell, a lot is going to depend what happens throughout the postseason. If he has a good, strong postseason, if I'm the Lakers, and if I'm the Lakers and LeBron's coming back and we're just, I'm not going to say fully running it back, but more or less bringing back this group, I feel like it's a lot more likely of, hey, let's re-sign D'Angelo Russell too. Let's enter into a deal that's worth 3-4 seasons, and off we go with that. And then that kind of removes any of the no trade nonsense and any of that other stuff that they've dealt with over the last few years with various players. And now we're kind of locked in as him as a core member. And I think we're trending more that way than, that's questionable. Let's maybe let him go. We could kind of reset. I think we're much more like Russell sticks in LA on a longer term contract.
Well, and the important thing to remember with this is if D'Angelo Russell were to walk away, that wouldn't free up a bunch of money for the Lakers. Correct. Not like if D'Angelo Russell went and signed somewhere for $30 million, you can say, oh, well, the Lakers didn't want to pay him $30 million. Now they've got $30 million to go spend somewhere. No, that's not how it works. Yeah. At most, based on my, again, the Lakers are very hard to figure out because LeBron James has that player option. D'Lo has the player option. You've got player options for guys like Christian Wood, like Jackson Hayes, Cam Reddish. And so there's a lot that's still up in the air. Max Christie is a restricted free agent or will be. So there's a lot of things that are up in the air right now about the Lakers. But when I'm looking at the numbers and trying to put together what I think will happen, they're going to be really, really close, if not perhaps over that second tier apron. So the amount of money, first of all, if they don't bring back D'Angelo Russell, maybe that opens up the taxpayer MLE for them. Maybe. But if you're the Lakers, you're going to get a player that's nowhere near the caliber of D'Angelo Russell if you have the taxpayer MLE to use. I could see a scenario where the Lakers really just have veteran minimums, but they would probably be better off just keeping D'Angelo Russell. But again, the question becomes, are they willing to go over that second tier apron in order to do it? I think they probably should be. I don't think they should be in the business of losing D'Angelo Russell for nothing, but we'll see how that plays out. How much, if the Lakers do keep D'Lo and he does want to stay in LA and he's had a lot of success this season there, what does it cost to keep him? What that number ultimately comes in at could have a major, major factor, in addition to LeBron and what happens with him, of course, could have a major impact on what kind of flexibility the Lakers are going to have on the market this summer.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there was a world where we discussed this last summer as they kind of built this team out. They re-signed some guys and we said, all right, well, Russell got the contract he got, which felt like maybe a slight overpay at the time last year, because that gave a little bit of flexibility if it's a shorter term deal. And if you take this contract, we'll give you the player option and give you a little bit of control in this whole process. And the reason the Lakers did that was a lot of it was that uncertainty with LeBron. If LeBron was locked, let's say LeBron was signed for the next three seasons already, the Lakers probably make some different decisions there, where it is, all right, we feel better about locking in the money because we've got LeBron. Because there was a world where it was, hey, we may be kind of resetting this team around Anthony Davis and Austin Reeves in the next year or so. So let's try to keep everything else in a more reasonable value where if we have to get out of it, we can trade these guys without a lot of worry. And that's where all this kind of locked in. So I think in D'Angelo Russell's case, now what's happened is he's had a very good, productive season. I think he's proven, and we talked about this at the time, what you love about D'Angelo Russell is he can scale up and scale down, which is he's become a different player. He wasn't able to do that in his first run with the Lakers, even with the Nets. He was, hey, man, I need 15, 20 shots a night. Otherwise, why am I out here? Now it's turned into, all right, when LeBron and AD are on the floor, I know I'm the third guy, maybe even the fourth guy if Austin's cooking, and you know, I'm just going to kind of play make and I'll do my thing. And that's huge because he also still, when a guy's out, all right, I can take 20, 25 shots and keep us in games and even in some cases win us games when other guys are missing. And that's massive. So I feel like if I'm the Lakers, I'm looking at it and saying, I can almost get there even if LeBron is still an unknown, and we all know LeBron likes to stretch his free agency out when he can. But even if he's still an unknown or out of the picture, I would still feel okay with committing to D'Angelo Russell. I'm not going to say, well, LeBron's gone, so you get $45 million. That let's not get silly. But I would say, I'm still giving you the contract I felt good about with LeBron, even if you're not here, because I think he's an important player for the Lakers. And I don't think it'll get to a point where the deal gets so crazy that it's on the back end. You're like, eh, this is not a great contract. I think it'll be okay no matter what.
Right. And that's where you want to be careful. You don't want to wind up with a negative value contract because this is part of why when they gave Anthony Davis's extension this last summer, I was talking about why that was such a big win for the team. And some people were saying, yeah, but is LeBron still going to be around? Are they going to move on? I said, no. The brilliance of that is that if LeBron does leave and the team says, hey, and I don't expect them to do this, but if they do say, we're going to tear it all down and we're going to rebuild and all of that, great. You flip Anthony Davis and you turn him into more assets. The same would be true of D'Angelo Russell. As long as you're careful with the kind of contract you give him, that doesn't necessarily limit your future flexibility. It just makes sure that you don't lose him for nothing. In the future, as long as the deal is right, and this is part of the reason why I like DeJounte Murray's contract so much. We talked about that a lot at the trade deadline. If in the future you need to pivot, if as long as you could sign him to the right kind of deal, you could always turn him into future draft capital or something like that if you have to. But again, the key is going to be finding the right number. But right now, he's been successful in LA. The Lakers are finding success with him. It's a feel-good story in some ways, coming back to the Lakers and finding a place. And, you know, Keith, just to put a bow on this, he had a comment last year about how he didn't quite feel like this was home. And I'm paraphrasing, but something to the effect of, you know, he's been traded before and he's never felt like any team is really committed to him and everything. It would be kind of cool to see the way that he's turned it on. And he talked about recently the reason why he's played so well this season was because of his son and that kind of, you know, the parental motivation there and all of that. For a team to finally say, you're our guy, to D'Angelo Russell, and we're going to commit X number of years to you. When so many teams have, I mean, like when he went to the Warriors, everybody knew he wasn't going to stay with the Warriors. Like he was ultimately going to get moved. So to finally be someplace where it's, we want you because you've been good for our team and we want to keep you. We want to commit to you for the long term in the NBA, who knows how long that truly is, but we want you to be our guy. That there would be a feel good element to it as well. So hopefully he does wind up sticking with the Lakers, but he's had a phenomenal season. And at the very least, he's going to add multiple years onto his contract, if not more money too, this summer.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he's put himself in this position by playing well. That's the most important thing when your players play well. So yeah, he's going to do okay for himself one way or another, whether it's with the Lakers or not. But I think we're both in agreement, it's probably going to be with the Lakers.